H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
That's right. I just started. Oh, great, fine. Let us start with JavaScript. Anyway, to do practice in JavaScript, we are going to cover some HTML, CSS stuff parallelly. So we are not specially allocating any time for HTML, CSS due to time constraint. But still, if you feel, you know, we have struck in any one place particularly because of HTML, CSS, please do stop me, do interrupt me, please don't hesitate, you know. If you are not able to understand some CSS stuff or HTML stuff, we will dig into that and we can discuss about it. Okay.
Okay.
Now, coming to JavaScript. As you know, JavaScript is one of the most popular client-side language, you know, the user-side language. And why we do need JavaScript is, just few minutes we will discuss about why and how. Okay, JavaScript can create HTML elements, JavaScript can change HTML content, JavaScript can change HTML attributes, it can change styles and it can validate data. So being discussed these points, instead of, you know, going theoretically, let me have one practical example which covers all these 5 points, which actually how it does, how actually JavaScript can create HTML elements, how JavaScript can change HTML contents, how it can change attributes, how it can change styles. Even though we are using some events and functions to discuss these points, that functions and events we are going to discuss in the coming sessions. The only motto is I am trying to give you the overview of how and why the JavaScript is going to be used. Of course, some part of code may be understandable since we are coming from the scratch. Some portion may not be. Just bear with me. Just let me start on file. Okay, let me go to Sublime. Students. ABP Ankit Dravesh Pavan. Okay, now file, open folder,
yeah,
done. Let me start a new file, sample1.html. So if you see in this HTML element, I don't have any elements apart from the HTML skeleton. I have head section,
yeah,
and I have body section. I don't have any elements. The first point what I am trying to cover is, how can I create HTML elements with JavaScript? It is very simple. So where my heading is a variable I have created, this how to create a variable and all those things we will discuss it later. Document dot create element, and here so I would like to create a heading. I have created a h1 element and I have assigned it to a variable called my heading. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Now, since I have created h1 element, I need some text which can be inserted inside the h1 element. For that, I am creating text variable and I am creating an element. Create text node. This hello world. Okay. Now the second line, is it clear? I have created a text variable and I have created some text and I assigned it to the variable. And this is inbuilt method and this is inbuilt method. Nothing to discuss about it. We have ready-made boilerplate code available in JavaScript. It is ready-made, what do you call it? Ready-made resources, that what we can assume. With this create element, you can create an element dynamically. With this create text node, you can create a text node dynamically and you can assign it to variable. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Now, since this text has to be inside the h1, what I am going to do, I am going to insert my heading dot append child. I am appending this text and now document. So I have h1 is ready, inside text is ready. I have inserted this text inside h1 and now I need to insert this h1 into the body. So I am capturing document.body dot, sorry, document.body dot append child my heading. So when I run this, I should be able to see my heading over there. See this, this is the dynamically created stuff by JavaScript. So this is what my first sentence means. The JavaScript can create HTML elements. Now the point is, if it can be done in one single line in HTML, why we need these four lines? Why we need these four lines? This will be the single straight away question, right? It will strike to our mind.
Yeah.
The reason is very simple. You just imagine, today you are having only one line and tomorrow you have received a requirement of saying that, so I am going to, I need a, what do you call it? I have a database of 1,000 number students and all these 1,000 number students has to be displayed on the web page. So can we able to do the 1,000 lines coding if it can be done with 4 lines? If it can be done with 5 lines, why should we need to do hard code, you know, to hard code 1,000 lines? But actually how it can be done is very simple. For that we are going to, come again?
Actually you dropped in between, you know, there was no voice at all.
I'm not getting.
You are not at all audible.
Yeah, audible, but clarity is not there. Yeah, I'm waiting for your question.
Hello.
Ah, hello, Bhavesh garu. Upon the, one second, I think. Yeah, please. What's your question?
Yeah, we couldn't hear what you were telling, like after why.
One second. Wait. Now can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
I think sometimes it is getting automatically muted.
Okay.
Now is it clear? Now can I proceed?
Now it's clear. Now it's clear. You can proceed.
Yeah. Okay. Now. Okay. What I mean to say, if this one line coding, if this heading can be done in one line in HTML, like straightforward, like H1 some word, some text here. So if it can be done in one line, then why we need it four lines? Because in normally in what happens, sometimes we may need to write, you know, display the entire data, maybe hundreds and thousands lines of code. That moment of time, we can, with the help of this dynamic coding, dynamic HTML creation, we can do it. That I will just demonstrate how it can be done.
For
I equal to 0. We will be discussing about these for loops in detail, but this is for the just demo purpose. If you are getting stuck, also no problem. Okay, that I will explain. I is less than 100. I plus plus. So I am going to cut this code. And I'm going to insert. If I run this, I will get 100 lines. See, 100 lines of code. This each line can be different sentence also. We can create different
yeah.
lines, different text. That when we start discussing about business logic, you know, I will explain you, but as of now, I am trying to explain you what JavaScript can help us, how it can help us to do this kind of stuff. That's it.
Okay.
Now let me remove this for loop. Now you have understood, right, how JavaScript can create HTML elements and how it can display. Now let me show that how JavaScript can change HTML content. How JavaScript can change HTML content. So I have written some code here, like some text in HTML. Okay, now for this I have given ID heading. So I want to change this text through JavaScript, but how it can be. So what should I do is, first I should capture this entire heading like this, document dot get element by ID heading. So it means go and pick the element whose ID is heading dot inner HTML equal to I am coming from JS. See this, I have created, I have modified through JavaScript. Clear? Okay. Now, JavaScript can change HTML attributes. Okay. What do you mean by attributes is, see, ID equal to heading. This is an attribute. Now, what I would like to do is, I would like to add any attribute or, you know, I would like to change attribute. For example, like this. document.getElementById. So I will write a class here, dot class r, okay, dot success cut this style. Background green. So I want to add this class dynamically through JavaScript, how it can be. Document dot get element by ID dot heading dot set attribute set attribute and now class for this I want to add this class and I run this I should be able to add an attribute here. Okay. Pawan garu, clear?
Yeah, clear.
So what I have did is, first point I have explained you how I can create HTML elements. Second point, how can I explained you how I can change the content inside the HTML elements. Third point, I have explained you how I can add an attribute. Fourth point, I can change CSS styles also. Styles. If, for example, I have this font color right now. It is black color, which is not good. So let us change the font color. Means style. How can we change? So the same thing. Take document dot get element by ID and get the element by its name. Okay. What you want to change style, okay. What you want to change font color, can be named as a color. And now let me give a color for this, white color. When I run this, I should have the white color. So I can change the HTML styles also. Another fourth point and last point. These are the few benefits of JavaScript and few points what JavaScript can do over HTML documents. Not everything. There are a lot more to do with JavaScript. But I'm showing you some sample functionalities, some few things what we can do with JavaScript.
Yeah.
And now, last one. Validating. Okay. What is mean by validating? For example, you just imagine I have a HTML form like this. Okay. Let me use a table here, tr here, and this td here, first name, td, input, text, and this. Last name, email, text okay, this email, and now in this last button, submit, just remove the text here. Border equal to 1. If you run this, I'll be having a simple form like this. Okay. Now.
Okay.
Let me add a function here. On click equal to submit. On click equal to add. Add function. Okay. Let me create a function. Function add in this. What exactly would like to do is if I am clicking this button, without adding first name, I should get an alert message. Please add first name. If I am hitting the button without adding last name, one alert for last name. Email, one alert for email. That is how we can create the validation.
Okay.